Hey guys, how you going? This is Eddie the Magic Monk. Welcome to a lesson on Excel. And in this first lesson, I just want to show you guys how to do some basic calculations in Excel and how to use Excel as a calculator, as well as using some basic cell referencing and basically just some useful stuff that you can do with Excel. So the first thing I want to do is talk about the referencing system. So as you can see, Excel is basically a lot of cells that you can put data in. So for example, I can put 3 in this cell, I can put 5 in this cell, I can put 7 in that cell, and I could have a whole heap of numbers, and all of this is our data. Okay, so they could mean something like a person's age or a person's height or weight or how much money they have, depending on what kind of data you're processing. Each cell has a cell reference. So for example, you can see the cell that I'm highlighting right now, that I'm focusing on right now, is cell E4. So E is the column heading and 4 is the row heading. So each cell is identified by its reference. So here, the cell reference is F8 and so on. So whatever cell you click on, you should be able to see the cell reference in this box here. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is talk about how to use Excel as a calculator. So instead of just typing a number in, if I want to do, for example, something like 5 plus 5, so you do that and you press enter, you see that nothing happens, right? Because Excel doesn't know that you want it to do a calculation unless you put the equal sign in front of it. So notice how if you want to edit the cell, you can just click up here in this text box and you can edit the contents of that cell. And I'm putting the equal sign at the front, and what that's going to do is make it do the calculation. So if I do 5 times 5, so the star symbol means times, it'll become 25. And if I put the divide symbol, which is a forward slash, it'll do 5 divided by 5, which is 1. Or if I do 5 minus 5, it equals 0. Now, you can also put in a combination of calculations. So for example, 5 times 5 plus 2, that'll give you 27, because Excel knows that it's got to do the times first. Right, but if you put 5 plus 5 times 2, then it's going to do the times bit first, so it's going to be 5 plus 10, which is 15. You can also put divide in there as well. So let's say I put in 5 divided by 5 plus 5 times 2, so it's going to do the 5 divided by 5 first, which is 1, plus 5 times 2 is 10, so 1 times 10 is 11. So make sure you do the maths tutorial on in algebra lesson 1 if you're not familiar with the order of operations. So I'm also going to do use the brackets now. So for example, if I put a bracket here, then what that's going to do is it's going to do whatever is in the bracket first. So it's going to do 5 divided by 10 and then times by 2. So it's going to be 1/2 times 2, which is going to be 1. And you can also put in a squared symbol. So for example, if you put to the power of 2, so to get this symbol up, you just have to press shift and the number key 6. And it's going to get the power symbol up. So it means 2 to the power of 2, which is 4. So it's going to be 5 divided by 10, which is 1/2, times by 4, which is going to be 2. Okay, so that's all the calculator stuff. Now, if you had some more numbers, so for example, 4, 6, 8, right? So you have all these numbers, which could be the answers from all of your calculation. And let's say I want to add all these numbers together. Now, in another cell, instead of typing in 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8, right, and you have to put equals at the front as well. Now, instead of typing in those numbers, what you can do is type in equals and then just click on that cell that you want to add and then press plus and then click on this cell and then plus and then click on that cell plus click on this cell. So you can see that the referencing for the cells come up as you click on them. All right, so why would you do this? Now you'll see the answer in a second. So I'm gonna press enter and it's added all of the cells for me. Now watch what happens when I update one of these cells. So if I update, if I change the number 6 to 7, this total is automatically updated for me. So that is a really useful feature. So instead of 4, I might put in 60. Instead of 8, I might put in 800, and it just adds everything for me. Now, instead of adding, you can obviously put times and divide and all that stuff as well, and it just does the calculation for you. So instead of E8, let's say for example you had another cell in F3, let's say that's 50, so you can just put in at the end of the formula plus, and you can just type in the cell reference, you don't have to click on it. So let's say instead of the E8, I'm gonna change that to F3, and it just does it all for you. So I hope that you find these features useful for whatever it is you want to do, and hope to see you again in another tutorial. See you next time.